Hello, Into Tomorrow fans. This is your weekly ITTV update. Do you receive our free once-a-week tech newsletter? Well, if you don't, it's very easy to sign up. You do want to get this in your inbox once a week. Come by our website at graveline.com. Just underneath the main video window, you'll see Tech Newsletter. Click on that, scroll down after you enjoy reading the current weeks, and click on Subscribe. It's time now for Chris Graveline and This Week in Tech History.
This week in 1877, Emil Berliner, the man behind so many inventions, came up with a little thing called the microphone. It's a good thing, too, because without him, it would be kind of hard for us to bring you Into Tomorrow each week. This week in 1872, George Westinghouse patented the air brake. Air brakes were and remain especially important to trains, big trucks, buses, and amusement park rides. This week in 1876, Alexander Graham Bell of Salem, Massachusetts, rang up a patent for his invention, the telephone. It was an invention, incidentally, that almost bankrupted his company in the beginning. And this week in 1954, Into Tomorrow host Dave Graveline was born in Miami, Florida.
Thanks, Chris. By the way, This Week in Tech History, is brought to you, as always, by tigerdirect.com/Dave. That's where you go when you need great prices on all sorts of computer equipment, supplies, and all kinds of cool consumer electronics gadgets. Being a fly on the wall no longer requires multiple components or tricky wiring. Rob Elmanza has been testing the digital private eye spy cam from Swan, and it's just one of the many cameras available for your home or business.
Security is one of the most popular topics our listeners are talking about these days. For example, parents want to monitor their babysitters and nannies taking care of their children, and your boss wants to make sure you're actually working on the job. Rumor has it Dave has a couple of hidden cameras around here, so I have to be careful. This camera may address those concerns. I'm talking about the digital private eye from Swan Security. It's got a hidden pinhole disguised within the logo, and it's disguised as motion detector. Basically, how it works is that it will detect motion in front of it. Once you use the bracket and hang it up on the wall, they recommend you hang it high on the wall. You can use the 64 megabyte SD card that comes with the package and insert it in the slot here on the left of the camera. This SD card will hold up to 1600 images that it captures every 30 seconds, or you can use up to 1 gig of memory. You'll have to plug in a 9-volt battery to a Silly adapter if you want to use it as a standalone camera, but you won't be able to connect it to the internet. What you have to do is install the software that comes with the package to your machine, and your computer must be on at all times if you want it on the network. This camera will record video and playback video in a speed of 30 frames per second, and you'll have to use a USB cord that is included in the package. One of the downsides that I really don't like is the Silly adapter, like I mentioned before. It's hard to conceal, so people are going to be wondering, what's that up there? Something else is that the USB cord is very short, so you have to be very close to your machine. It's only about 2 feet long. This camera is available now for about $120 and $150 wherever you buy it. It's the digital private eye from Swan Security. Now back to you, Dave.
Thanks, Rob. If you have yet to enter our big giveaway, it's the St. Patty's Day Palm Trio Giveaway. You might be one of the 6 lucky lads or lassies to win a Palm Trio. Come by the website at graveline.com, click on the lucky leprechaun, and good luck.